So we wanted to do a little craft so we can still celebrate the cherry blossom. Here is what it looks like, just in case you're joining us for the first time. We are going to be making, we're gonna be making this fun little craft here. Some basic supplies that you are going to need for this is, first and foremost, something that you're gonna be making the cherry blossoms on. I tried it earlier on a piece of paper. It does work, however, the thicker that you put on the paint, it could seep through and take longer to dry. So just be careful if you do it on paper that you have something underneath so it doesn't bleed through onto a table or different things. I am going to be using a canvas. I happen to have this big gigantic one lying around, so this was the perfect opportunity to do something fun with it. You can do different things as well, cardboard, etc. Just something to be able to craft on. So those are the supplies that we're going to need to put them on. I did make sure to bring a few different water bottle sizes. This one's a pretty big one. You do want a water bottle or some sort of material that has the bumps on it. If you do something that is flat, it's not going to get the texture of the actual flower petals. So as you can see on this one, it has 5 bumps. They are different. So even though this one has the same amount of bumps, you can see, I don't want to like tip this one too much because it doesn't have lid, one is a little bit more indented than the other one. And then I did pick 2 kind of smaller ones as well. The ginger, I almost said gingerade, Gatorade and ginger ale. The ginger ale bottle has them a little bit closer together than this water bottle. So you can see it when it's in that angle. So again, the pattern template that we had seen in the image to come to this event only has one set of dots all around. I'm actually going to use all 4 because I think it's going to be really fun to show some different sizes of the flowers and the petals. And as we know, flowers don't all bloom on the same time. So those are the 4 water bottles that I have brought with me. Again, you can use anything that has the little indents on it. I noticed the iced coffee container in my fridge had some pretty cool textured bottoms on it as well. So again, we're going to use our resources. Some other things you are going to need are paints. Now the 2 main ones I'm going to use are azalea pink, so it's just like a flower color, and I'm going to use rose shimmer, which happens to be metallic. Not sure how this one's going to come out, which is why I wanted to try it. We're here together. We're here to use our imagination and experiment. If you don't have pink, that's okay, because we can get really creative and use red and white. When we do that, I poured a lot of red on the plate and white next to it. And when you want to mix it into the pink, you want to do a little bit of white at a time to be able to get the color. You don't want to just mosh it all together because it may not come out the way you want it. And then some other things that I do have a rose glitter here. Not sure. We might be able to add some fun at the end. And then I have a black for the stem. Okay. Some other things. I have some variety of paintbrushes here, a pencil. I quickly sketched kind of the idea of where I wanted the trunk or the tree branches to go, a cup of water, and then paper towels. I always bring paper towels to a craft. You never know if you're going to need them. And the last thing I have is paper plates. So what I did is I already put out the 2 different color pinks that I showed you, the azalea pink and the metallic, on a plate. I'm just gonna leave them there. That's how they flattened out, almost close to one another. 3 different things can go there. You can have the azalea pink, the rose shimmer, and then you can kind of combine them. So we're gonna try that and see. And then on my second plate, I have the red and white. In case I run out of pink, I can mix them. The white is here, I know it's a little bit harder to see. And then the black for my stem. Okay, so that's it. I mean, pretty much something to draw on, a water bottle, a paintbrush for the stem and our paints. Okay, so I'm gonna leave this out. When I first tested earlier with the water bottles, I noticed that the first or second time that I pushed down, the whole image doesn't come through. So the little indent, the center part of the flower may not come through. Now, a few different things we can do with that. We can just go with it and add something in. You can try doing a different color later, or we can just keep re-dipping it. Okay? So I do see we have some friends here. Say hi. And then we're going to get started painting. I am going to pull up the video on my phone again because it's pretty far away. And sometimes I don't get to see the messages. So let me know you're here, that we're ready to get started. We're going to jump right in because I'm excited. Let's do this. Let me turn my volume off. Cool. All right. So, like I said, I quickly sketched kind of the idea of where I wanted the branches to go. Everybody can do something different. Really, once we kind of get going with the water bottles and the prints, the possibilities are endless. You can even go right over a branch that you already made that you didn't want to use anymore. That's perfectly fine. Let's see. So, we can use... Not everyone has that one. I'm trying to use something that we can all use and have. So I'm going to use a little bit of a bigger paintbrush then. Fun fact, I almost just said toothbrush. We are going to use a little bit of a bigger paintbrush. I want to make sure that I evenly put out the paint. Because especially once we start blotching the water bottles, it's gonna get messy. It's going to be great. We want to make sure that that kind of evenly dries out. But making sure we have enough paint on our paintbrush, okay? Which is totally fun and different because on my Easter craft, I was like, use the paint in the lid. Now I sprawled them all over plates. So that's kind of funny. Hi, Gail. Thanks for watching. You know what? It could even try to gather these supplies next time and do it another day. You know, April showers, which it's raining for the next week. Bring May flowers. You could make this in May as well. All right. So I'm going to quickly start here. Again, like I said, with my little branch, the possibilities are really endless on what you want to do here. Even if they don't branch out all the way, you can definitely add them in later. Need a little bit of a thicker one with some super fun branches sticking off. I am gonna pat this down. There is a little bit of a glob here, so like I said, we want to make sure it's kind of evenly distributed, so that way we can get those flower petals down there. So again, just going all over the place. You can do what you want. You know, if we put some here, maybe they were falling off the tree. That does happen. I have been to the Cherry Blossom Festival and they were all over the ground, which was absolutely beautiful. And I just sketched out with a pencil kind of the pattern. I saw this idea and then I remembered about Cherry Blossom Festival and how I missed it, so I wanted to do this with everybody today. Gail, since you commented, if you're still here, how are you doing, my friend? All right, let's round that one out up there. All right, so because I brought this gigantic canvas, I'm gonna show you actually real quick before I pick it up, just in case. I'm gonna just get rid of these big blotches up here. As we've all seen when we've picked up branches out in the woods and stuff, they never look the same. So some of them are broken, have a little bit of a bigger end, whatever we want, okay? Sure, I think that's great because you want to make sure that you're leaving room for us to actually put the cherry blossoms on. All right, this is what I was able to quickly come up with here. Why not? Kind of gives us a little bit more thicker texture up and out. What do we think? Are we ready to keep moving on? Get to the fun part with the water bottles? Good. All right, I'm going to put my black paintbrush in here because we're not using anything close to that size again. Which is great. I'm gonna move all my paintbrushes over. I'm gonna move my paints over. I left them upside down because I was running low on the pinks. How funny. And I was like, maybe I can change up the color, but then I realized that defeated the purpose of a cherry blossom. So when I tested it, I did a tan branch and green leaves. So you can really use whatever you have available. I know Gail was talking about supplies. If you happen to only have, you know, three colors and white is one of them, you can definitely make a bunch more from there, which is awesome. I'm going to start with the biggest one that I have. I think comparably, yeah. Oh, they fit perfectly in one of them. That's perfect. So, one thing to remember, this is gonna have paint all on it. You can't put it back down on the table. So it's another reason why paper towels are gonna be our friend. I'm gonna fold it in half just so I can kind of leave them put there. All right, are we ready, friends? So here's the bottom of the water bottle. Let's do the azalea pink first. I feel like it really represents the color of a cherry blossom first. So it's really simple. You don't have to push hard at all. Oh, good. I'm glad you're doing well, Gail. I know we miss everybody, and I can tell you I really miss hugs as well. I'm doing great, thank you. Like I said, other than missing hugs. So as you can see, I kind of did a pretty good dip. I left it in there. I wanted to show you guys the bottom. See? Now it's not going to come out like that on the canvas because all of those pieces are not easily exposable to the canvas. So again, I'm going to dip it just one more time because this is that first kind of go at it. Actually, real quick, let me see, since this is our first little piece, about dipping it on paper first. I will show you when I'm done why I'm gonna just dab it onto the paper. Watch, it's gonna work perfectly. Kind of. Okay, so the dot in the middle did actually work, but there was a lot of extra paint on it, so it kind of made a mess. So I wanna make sure, as my hand sticks to it, I'm gonna use it just as it is right now. All right, so I'm gonna put this one here. And again, I'm on a canvas that's not 100% sturdy underneath. And fun fact, I'm gonna scoot this back. The center didn't show up. So I think we're gonna get really creative when that happens. All right, let's do one or two more here. Again, I wanna just let it drip a little bit. There was a lot of paint on it before. It could just be that color was sitting for a little bit longer. It could be the type of paint. But yeah, so we're gonna let it drip one more time, and then we're gonna use it. All right. So this helps by letting it drip a little bit to A, not make a big gigantic mess, but also time for things to kind of dry and settle. So the next placement, I think I'm gonna put it right here and see what we can get. All right, let's see. It is really drippy, but that's okay, 'cause I think we're gonna be just fine. I'm gonna put it right over the branch. I'm gonna just swivel mine a little bit, like I said, because it is on a canvas and there's nothing underneath it, which I should have thought of ahead of time. But that's what I love about doing these live videos with everybody. We get to learn as we go. Let's do one more of the bigger bottle in this color. Let's do it. All right, we're gonna let it drip for a second. I really do think it's the texture, of this pink paint. So, I might even just dab it onto the paper. Perfect. Let's go up here. I'm gonna let that one just be on the top of the branch, and I'll show you. I'll slide it back into view. The canvas was just way too big for view. Oh, and that one got a little middle. All right. I'm gonna leave that on the paper, and here is what we have so far. Okay. Perfect. Oh, hey Brooke, thank you. All right. So now I'm gonna go down to the next size that I had. Again, this one had a little bit of the higher bumps, so there's gonna be less of kind of that inner circle for us to see. I think it'll give it some really great texture. Now I'm gonna use the metallic rose shimmer one. I'm just gonna scroll this real quick. Sorry, friends. How funny it would be if my braid actually went into the paint. Why not? All right, let's use the rose metallic one. This one's definitely thicker. As you can see, it's stuck to the blade a little bit more. And when I was pouring it out of the bottle, it was definitely more sticky. So I'm gonna turn this around. And what's really great about these is, like I said, I tried them all out with green paint and then I just quickly washed them. And now I can use them. They're like brand new. So you could use these over and over again to create different crafts. If there's something else that this sparked in your mind, you could do that too. And because it's the first time I'm using this metallic here, I'm going to dip it onto the paper first. which hopefully is still in view, perfect. And honestly, that just came out beautiful. So let's just stick this one up here. Again, I'm gonna swivel just a little bit on mine because it is a canvas. How fun is this? It's like a little bit of a workout too, I like it. This is a different type of workout. All right, so let's let this paint dry a little bit. So let me, I'll show you how that one came out up there. I will definitely show this a little bit closer. I'm gonna have to stand up for that. But I want to show you because it really looks cool with the different materials, metallic and regular. I'm running out of room on my paper. Okay. So now by doing that, I missed. There we go. All right. Where should we put this next one? I'm thinking we should kind of buddy them just a little bit. So after this corner drips, I think I'm gonna put this one right on the edge of this as well. I think it looks really good with the black. All right. How is everyone doing today? See, we have more friends on with us. Hello, everyone. We are making cherry blossoms because we just missed that beautiful day. I'm working on a canvas right now, but you can do this craft on paper. I did it earlier on paper. And you can also do it on anything, cardboard, different things. Okay, let's do two more. Ciao. I like that. I was just talking about Italian earlier. Okay, this one's really drippy. So, I'm running out of room on my paper. Let's move that one over on it to its side. Dip that one real quick. Okay, get the two corners. So it's a little bit of a juggling game, which I happen to really enjoy. We'll put this one here, because nothing's down here below the tree as if it's falling. Hi, Teresa. How are you, darling? Okay, so I've officially done 6 cherry blossoms, which I'm gonna get up and show you now. All right, I can't hold it too far too long, but as you can see, we have a little bit of the metallic color. That's the one I just did, so I'm gonna flip it over and show you upside down on the top so you can see kind of the different colors and textures here. You have a metallic and a pink, but I don't wanna have it get too drippy. So let's keep going. 2 water bottles down. What do you say we do the ginger ale? Let's do the ginger ale. What do we think on that? I miss you too. I miss everybody. This is crazy, but we're doing great. We're here. We get to chat. So we've done our azalea pink. We've done our metallic shimmer, rose shimmer. What if we try to get it right into the middle of the plate? So we have some azalea pink and some rose shimmer. What do we think? I think that's going to be amazing to try. So let's place it right there. Oh man, this is going to be rough to keep doing over and over again. All right, let's place it there. Oh my goodness. I hope this comes out how it looks on the bottom of the bottle. All right. I think I'm going to put it right. Oh, can't see on the screen. I think I'm going to put it right here, right in the middle. Kind of that. I'm just going for it. I'm just going for it. That's a part of art. We just go for it and we make it our own. And a swivel again because I'm on a canvas. Ooh. So what that just did was 2 azaleas, 1 rose shimmer, and 2 partials. That was fun. Let's do it again. All right. Let's hope I'm staying accurate. Okay. I think this branch is missing some, so let's put one over here. Thank you so much, T. Fun fact about this craft, I did not create it. I cannot take credit. I had this pinned on my Pinterest for well over a decade. It was like the second thing I've ever pinned. So I was like, let's just do this. It's beautiful. We've missed the cherry blossom day. So that one is a full-budded flower. All right, let's kind of dip this out the majority. Ooh, that was kind of cool. All right, we'll get one more of our little hybrid flower. And I have an idea. All right, I think that's enough paint. All right, that's Anne, how did you know that that's what we're gonna do? So my friend Anne said, dip the end of a paintbrush in the paint and then make it the middle of the flower. Anne, I adore you for saying that. And let me dip this one real quick, and then I had that idea too, and I'm gonna show you what I was thinking. Let's put this one. Ooh, where do you guys think? Should we fill the gap right here? I think we should fill the gap because we can always do something fun down here on the bottom. I think we should fill the gap. Love that idea. You guys are amazing. Oh wait, you know what I'm gonna do after it drips? I'm gonna turn it the other way so the metallic's on this side, because both of them kind of have it over there. So, let that drip. You know what? I'm just gonna quickly go for it because it's still dripping. Amazing. Cool, let's fill this gap. And again, you can do as little or as much as you want. One of my favorite parts of fall is when everything is really full and all the different colors are there and the trees, multiple colors all the way up. So we're definitely gonna add more to this. So back to Anne's idea. So when I first showed the paint colors, we had azalea, a metallic shimmer, red, white, and black, but I also had a little bit of a glitter pink, and it's a rose colored. So I think that's what we're gonna use for the center dots, because it could give it a different color and texture. And the inside of a flower is always a little bit different. So what do we think on that? What do we think on the glitter being the inside dot? I love it. All right. So now we've done kind of all the colors and a different idea. I think let's try to work together, because I know everyone doesn't have, you know, multiple shades of pink. So let's see about, I almost reached to mix paint with the water bottle. Let's see about making our own tone of pink. So we're gonna do that by mixing in, again, I have red. It's hard to see because it's white paint on a white plate. I have white here, a whole big glob there. You wanna slowly add the white into the red. You don't wanna just mix them all together, okay? So I'm gonna slowly just add some white in here. You wanna do that so you can actually control the color that you're making, because almost immediately, and I'll show you, it starts to turn pink. I think we can get that basic idea of our color wheel, but just in case, that's my fun fact for the day. So this one is kind of a little bit more salmon-like, a little bit more of that darker tone. So I'm gonna show you what I have. Again, we're gonna have to mix quite a bit more because the water bottle's not gonna fit in this little spot. But what do we think about this color of pink? Like I said, it is a little bit more salmon color. Let me try to get the plate angle with the lighting. It's hard to see. What do we think about this pink color right here? I think we can do it. I think that could be our winner. We just have to make enough of it. Sorry, the comments aren't scrolling, so I'm scrolling for them. All right, so let's work on mixing a little bit more red into there. Let's work on mixing a little bit more white, so that way we have a broader area to dip our water bottle in. Okay, I'm just slowly kind of going around like a mixer in a mixing bowl. I did add a lot more red into that, so it's still kind of too dark. So I'm going to just add a little bit more white. And what'll be really fun is you can control this color. And I've said that before, but what I mean by that is if I fully don't mix it in, we might even get a little bit of the red and white. And if you've seen a cherry blossom, some have the little polka dots on it. Some are kind of like an ombre color. So we really can make it our own cherry blossom. I'm almost done mixing it. Like I said, there's still a little bit more white, but if I hold up this paintbrush, to these two pinks here. Definitely a different color, so that's very exciting. It's going to fill this out even more. Just trying to give you guys some different ideas to continue to work on this at home during this time. I love a fun game of using our resources. It's one of my favorite things to do. Get creative with what we have. Okay, I'm going to use this last little water bottle. It's just like the first. Whoa, they're all stuck on the paper. That is brilliant. It's like the first big one we used, where we used the azalea pink, but smaller. That was awesome. Okay, so let's carefully position it in the new pink we got. Oh, and actually, I've got some white on there, which I'm not 100% of a fan of because it's only on two petals, so I'm going to mix it in on there, which is good to know that we're quite out of frame on that. But because of that, what I'm doing right now, ooh, there's a little bit of red on that one and a little bit of red on this one. So what I did is I mixed all the ends. So it's a little bit of a marbled look. All right, let's give it a go. Let's fill it in. I'm gonna put it up here next to our lovely metallic ones. Again, if you're just joining us, hello. We're making cherry blossoms out of water bottles and paint. Ooh, that's very different. I like it. All right. I think we need one up here. There's a gap up here. Wait, let me pull it back just a little bit more. Gap right up in here. And I honestly think we kind of need one right here. So we'll do two more of those. Again, I'm getting a little bit of the red in here and a little bit of the white, which is not a bad thing. I just want to mix it in just a little bit. It's actually creating that marbled effect, which is really cool and unique. So really, let's do this one up here. And then what I'm thinking is we kind of need more of the bigger ones again. So we're gonna have to use that. All right, let's dip it again. And this is out of a pink that we made, mixing red and white. Ooh, this one's got a lot of color swirled into here. And I didn't even have to do anything. This is fantastic. I love this. All right. Let's put this one right here on this branch because we were kind of missing one there. What do we think, friends? Everyone that's here, what do we think? Is this something you can achieve at home with some supplies that you have? Again, it doesn't have to be this big, gigantic canvas. I just literally have had it lying around for probably a year. Over a year, actually. I recall because I did another painting and it was sitting right behind it. Which I did almost hang up behind me, but the angle wouldn't have showed you the painting I made. So, last one with our little swirled granite looking darker pink flower. Hi Liz, how are you doing? Oh my gosh, that's a great idea, Anne. It would be cute across a plain cotton curtain valance. You know what? This is acrylic, which does tend to be multi-surface, which is awesome. All right, so I really want to show you guys this marbled look that we've created together, but I'm not 100% sure if it's going to show up. So I'm going to let this just sit for 1 minute. I'm going to detach, because it's stuck on the paper, should have known, the big water bottle, because I want to use this one again. I think we're definitely missing some pattern with that. Some of those bigger spots for sure. Hi, Gail. Yeah, it is a great idea, right? And you are just, watch out. I'll get curtains and we'll make something fun. We could do different colors. Depends on what you were thinking. All right, I'm going to get as much of this off as possible. Like I said, I used water. We do have some water here because I put the paintbrush that we made the branches out of. I'm not too worried about it because I think mixing these colors have given it a great texture and a great look, which is exciting. So I think I got the majority of the paint off. So now we've just got a mess. But that's why I keep a trash can with me. All right. We've got a big pink one here and a big pink one here. A smaller metallic one. What if we did a bigger metallic one down here? So now this is the game of seeing what else we can add. I'm gonna show you guys kind of what we've come up with. You let me know. You let me know if it's enough or if we should add maybe two more. I'm thinking maybe two more somewhere.